I just made this pedestal table out of spalted maple. Made it for a good friend of mine. Let me show you how I made it. As is usually the case, I start at the miter saw. I cut down the rough stock to approximate length. These initial pieces will be used for the column of the table. Once I have the pieces I need, I move to the jointer to flatten one side of the board. I need to joint one edge as well. Next stop, the planer, to get all the pieces to a consistent thickness. As you can see, this is the column glue-up. I need to start thinking about the top. It'll be made of two pieces glued together. While the top and column are being glued, I made a template for the legs. I got it just the shape that I wanted, and then I rough cut the stock. Then I took the template and I attached it to the stock, and now you can see here I'm trim routing it to the proper shape. I do that to all four legs. Using the blue tape and CA glue trick, I attached all the legs together so that I could sand them and get them all identical. I use a variety of sanders to accomplish this task. Once the glue dried on the column, I took it and trued it up in the planer and the table saw to get it nice and even and square. Now it's on to lathe work. It took me about an hour and a half to complete the column on the lathe. I find it very soothing to turn something on the lathe. My initial goal with the column was just to get it into a nice cylinder. Before I moved on to the next phase, I wanted to sand it down. Here I'm marking the locations for the various transitions that I'll have. It's beginning to take shape. Just the way I want it. I'm going to use a sliding dovetail to attach the legs. Here I'm using a straight bit to hog out the majority of the material. As you can see, this isn't the best bit. Now I can complete the dovetail. Onto the matching part of the dovetail that I need to put on the legs. I have to do several passes and kind of sneak up on the fit. After each of these two passes, I will test fit it and the leg. This was a little precarious since there wasn't much material to balance it on, but it worked out fine. I'm cutting the top portion of the dovetail off the leg. This will provide a much better fit onto the column. After the piece is removed, there's a little chisel work to clean up the edges. I chose to round over the edges of the legs on the router table. The legs are ready for glue up on the column. I'm using a scrap piece of wood here with some tape on it to ensure that all of the legs are flush with the bottom of the column. While the legs are drying on the column, I need to do a little prep work on the top. I had to use some epoxy to fill some imperfections in the wood. I cut this pattern template with the jigsaw for the top, and I'm sanding it perfectly round. Just making sure the little wings stay flat for when I do the top. Sometimes you've got to use different methods to get things accomplished. I'm using the chuck point that I used on the lathe for centering up on the column. I'm going to drill a hole and put a dowel in, which will align the column and the top. I forgot to film it, but I made these two support wings similar to the legs and installed them similar to how I put the legs on. I'm using the pattern here to true up the tabletop on the router. Thank you. I'm using a round over bit to round over the top edge of the table. I then switch to a chamfer bit to chamfer the bottom edge. I use the hole in my pattern to center up the hole in the bottom of the table in order to drill the hole for my dowel. I drilled elongated holes in the support pieces, and they are running perpendicular to the grain of the top for best support. And then I will screw them in, and it'll allow some expansion and contraction. I'm using an awl to mark the hole locations, and then I will drill holes to accept the screws. The top is now secure, 3 coats of water-based poly, and here is the final product. Thanks for watching. Comment, like, share, and subscribe. Have a great week.